Okay. Remember I said I couldn't find my notes on my tail? And remember I said you might want to watch the video through once. I'm backing this up. I don't like how thick this is with four wires. So what we're going to do is untwist, if I can, just twist these two wires together down about an inch and a half. So like that much. And then cut one there. Just get rid of it. It's too much. Okay. And then you can take this and fold it back. So now we're just, the fold is just one wire. And it will meet back up with these two wires. And then now we can twist that together. It was too bulky. We had to take some of that out of there. Because the next step is to get some wool on this tailbone. And I might also thin this Surrey out a little bit. So if I cut it this way rather than just going straight across, it'll fringe it out a little bit and make it not such a chunk to try and get in there. Okay. All right, I'm gonna use, we have a nice, I can turn this wax off, huh? We have a nice bundle of light gray, and I need not very much. So I'm gonna take about a 3-inch piece, split it, pulling off about a 1/2 inch of it. So it's even less than a half. And I just wanna start at the top of the tailbone and wrap this as tightly as I can. Smoosh all this Surrey down. Smoosh it.
I know smoosh as a word.
It's still too much. It's still too much. Get rid of it. It's too much to smoosh. Also, point this up a little bit because he's going to get some butt cheeks and stuff, and you don't want his tail to look like it's coming out between his hind legs. You want it to be look like it's in line with his spine. It's a little fudge that we have to do. So just get this as tight as possible. Please look at reference pictures when you're making your project, because you'll see what it should be.
Sounded like a public service announcement.
Yes. This is your public felting announcement. Use Google Images or your own donkey or pictures you might have. All right, I just want that to stay tight, so I'm stabbing it in. Alrighty then, back to off-white. We're gonna take another nice, we're still wrapping. 6-inch piece, split it in half. I think I'm going to work with quarters on the head and neck here this time so I can really target areas. So I split the 6-inch piece into half, and then I split one half into quarters. And I want to go one on the neck. I'm going to start at the base. I want to use this whole piece on the neck so I'm not moving up too quickly. This, judging how much wool you have and how far it will go, kind of comes to you after a lot of critters. And then this piece I want to use on the head, and I really want to concentrate it on the back of the head and keep a conical shape. So I need a little bit more on the nose, but I'm going to linger here, move down and back, and finish here, and it should give me a wider back of the head. Linger meaning wrap more there. And now I'll move down. Keep it really tight because all of the face pieces have to felt well into this wrapped core armature. And then now I'll let this finish off the back of the head. So yeah, that gives me a real tapered kind of cone shape. Alrighty, I still have a half of a 6-inch piece, so I'm going to split this into quarters, and I'm going to do the top of each hind leg. So I want to do actually what I did on the head at the top of the leg. Don't go down to the hock. Keep everything an inch up from the hock. So I'm going to start by wrapping around the top of the leg, linger there. I'm doing this a little bit looser because I want the opportunity to be able to felt it flat rather than like a, this is real round and log-like. So I'm just working it a little bit looser. And then I'm gonna come down and then I'm gonna turn around and go right back up at an angle so that the back of the leg gets wider at the top. Nice and smooth, but slightly loose. So that I can set it down like this and stab it from the inside and really flatten it out. Sun's coming out for us today, Milo.
It's about time.
It has. It's been a pretty broody gray few days. Same thing over here, keeping most of the wool at the top. And then when I get down here, I want to turn right around and go back up. Sorry, I'm probably not at a very good angle.
It's not terrible.
Okay, and then I'm gonna stab from the inside out to flatten it out. You got any questions to ask me?
Questions?
I just wanted to say ass. Okay.
I do. What's a boy donkey called?
I don't know. What?
I can think about that. It's not a joke.
Oh. Oh, what's a boy donkey called? I should know this. I know what a female donkey is called.
That?
A Jenny.
Yes. What is the boy?
See, his left leg's longer. Okay. Okay. We need to do this step to the tops of the front legs. We need a nice long skinny piece for this. So let's take a 6-inch piece and get quarters and then stretch those quarters out nice and skinny. Oh, I know this.
I know. I'm not telling you either. There's people out in YouTube land screaming
yelling it. A Jack.
Yes.
Yes. Jack and Jenny.
Yeah.
So all I'm going to do is start at the top of the leg, go down to the knee, which is halfway between the elbow and the pastern, and go back up the leg. And this I want to keep skinny. Don't let this build up too much. It's actually no, what we're gonna do is we're not going back up. We're gonna go down and we're gonna wrap a little knee like this. So when we get to where the knee is, you wanna keep this ribbon narrow. If you let it be real wide, you can't target the knee. So pull it, control it narrow, and then right here, you're gonna figure eight right in one place to make a little bump. So I'm just crisscrossing within this one little quarter inch area. And that's going to give me a little knee joint. And you got to stab that. And when you stab it in on itself so it stays knuckly, you know, like a joint. Okay.
Knuckly.
So we're just starting at the top of the leg, getting another layer of wool going down here. Stretching it out so I can really keep it tight and under control. And then when I get to the knee, I'm going to crisscross. Donkeys are to horses like cats are to dogs. Did you know this?
Really?
Yes. They're a little bit aloof. Like, they don't really care what you have to say so much.
Okay.
But when they want attention, they just run in and get it. But they're not as, they're not as eager to please.
Like a cat. So, this fast.
Sometimes horses aren't either, but you can usually...
Well, this talks more about them being stubborn. It says donkeys have a reputation for being stubborn because they're more cautious. If a situation seems unsafe, they dig in their heels and won't move, and that you have to work to gain their trust more than a horse, which is kind of cat-like.
Yes.
Dogs will kind of stupidly run into a situation with enthusiasm.
Okay. Couple of things. Let's do the hock joint, since we've done the knee joint. And I also want to do that before we get too much more wool on here, because it becomes difficult to incorporate it. So this time I'm going to use gray. Their legs do all kinds of different coloring. You could keep using off-white here. I think you have enough oatmeal in your kit that you could use. You could use the oatmeal. But I'm going to use the gray because it'll blend into what we're doing, and it's real easy to blend away. So I'm going to take a 4-inch piece and split it in half and stretch that out gently so it's nice and long and skinny. Alternate would be to take a longer piece and split it into quarters. And starting at the bottom of this... off-white upper leg wrap that we did, I'm going to come down to the hock, and then I exaggerate the bend in the hock. Like, I'll make it almost a 90 degrees. And then I really want to wrap here, and then wrap here, and then wrap here, and then wrap here, and never wrap the bend. So I come around here, and then I come real tightly this way. And then I come around here and I go real tightly that way. And one more time. And that builds up a nice little joint there. And then the rest of it, I'm just going to take it up and stab that flap. What you looking up there, Milo?
I'm posting some behind the scenes.
Ooh. Little tease.
Yes.
Actually, I have enough of this piece that I stretched out that I'm just going to use that rather than stretch out a whole other piece. So once I'm here, I'm going to do a tight wrap up here and then cut through the center and do a tight one here. And one more time, and I think I'm done. Just let this fringe come up and blend. There we go. Hawks. All right, now that we have those on, we can do, we need a top wrap on each top of the four legs. So I'm gonna take a, about a 5-inch, somewhere between 4 and 6 inches piece and split it into quarters. 1/4 is gonna go at the top of the back leg. So this is gonna look like this. It's gonna start on the back. This is what pulls the leg together with the body. It's gonna go around the top of the hind leg one full time and then return to the back. And that's a lot of fuzz that you have to felt down there because that's not getting wrapped really. And then you felt this flat from the inside of the leg out. Oh dear, I don't like to see them bent in unnatural ways. It's upsetting. And then I'll take my other quarter. I start on the back. I go around the top of the leg one full time. Now, okay, if I really want to do it the same, I gotta wrap a direction that's not comfortable to me. And return to the back. Usually I do it the opposite direction because that's what's comfortable to my hand, and then they do end up a little bit. Even though it's the same steps, they end up a little lopsided. So I just made myself do it the same way. So if you look at it from the inside out, that should further create, you know, that triangular cone shape there. All right, and then we have another half of 2 more quarters of that 4 or 5 inch piece, and we're gonna do the front legs. This is gonna start on the shoulder, go down to the elbow, and come back up to the shoulder. So actually hold the fluff on the body, maybe 2 wraps down to the elbow, and then come back up and return to the body.
Turkish proverb.
All right. I'm hoping this is gonna give me some real insight into my life.
One searches for someone else's donkey while singing songs.
This is a proverb.
Yes. A Turkish proverb. One searches for someone else's donkey while singing songs.
Like they're happy to do it, or the songs get the donkey to come, or, I mean, find the donkey.
That one's perhaps the most random one I could find. I just found it interesting. You want one to really think about?
Yes.
The communal donkey gets the heaviest burden. That's a French proverb. That one's deep.
These are all kind of like, okay, maybe I'm dense and I can't see the depth to it. What's your take on
that? The communal donkey gets the heaviest burden. Well, people aren't going to burden their own donkey. They're going to burden the one that everyone can use. It could go like,
Like, people are selfish?
Yes!
Use your own donkey.
No, they will burden...
The communal one.
Yes.
Poor communal donkey.
Burdeners.
I think we need to take a break.
Okay.
Okay. We're going to build up this chest and belly a little bit. Before I do, I want to put another wrap on here. So I'm going to work with a nice 8-inch piece or so. Take half of it. Half an 8-inch piece and just go around this body here. One more time. Let's get this on here. Nice and smooth. Consistent. That's what this core wool is so good for. Okay. We're going to make a couple of shapes on the Zoli tool. If you don't have a Zoli tool, get one. No, you can just fold or, you know, stab it. The chest is going to be, let's see, we can use this other half of an 8-inch piece, except we're going to make it quarters. So we've got this quarter of an 8-inch piece. And I want to wrap about a 2-inch rectangle on the Zoli tool. And whenever I wrap a shape on the Zoli tool, it's good to be able to go out and back. That gives the shape some structure. If you just go one direction and then you slide it off the Zoli tool, it's going to want to unravel. Okay, so that's your chest. And let's go ahead and make our two belly pieces. So for the belly, you're gonna take a lot, like the length of your stabbet plus a little bit more. So it's about an 18-inch piece.
Whoa.
I know, they have big bellies. It's like Santa Claus. You make your Santa and you think you're making them nice and fat, and they're never fat enough. And then you're gonna wrap, you're gonna wrap the Zoli tool in about a 3-inch area, and you're gonna crisscross. Am I staying on camera?
Ish.
I'm probably popping off. Keeping the majority of the wool in the middle.
This is easier than folding. They really should get a Zoli tool.
Yeah, it is easier than folding. So that's one. See how that just like condenses down into not so much. I don't know why I'm having a hard time working where I should be working.
There's a tripod up in your space.
So I'm trying to keep most of the wool in the center. It'll give you a tapered pillow. Okay, we're gonna put the chest on first. And that just goes through the front legs, and then you want the top of it to just rest on the sides of the collarbones, citroclavicle. I'm always trying to act like I know. I'll just act like I know.
What's your shoulder bones?
Your shoulder blades?
Those aren't clavicles.
Speculum. Scapula.
Send me the scalpel. I don't know any of them. You could just tell me like you know. Say it with authority.
It's an SP word. I think it's scapula. I hear it. I hear it in yoga a lot. I should know these things. They don't have a super like proud, you know, chest like a goat or a reindeer. So this is just to get some wool in here. I'm not trying to shape it into, you know, a sharp angle or anything. Okay, that's the way it looks. And then these two belly bumps, I usually end up with like a rounder side, like a crescent, and a flatter side. So I try to put the flat side towards the top and the rounder side towards the bottom. And initially, you're just going to stab it onto the side. It's not going to feel like it's holding very well. This needle has 3 needles. This is my for real tool. Okay, and then same thing on the other side. This one has no definitive shape. So see how they're, it's not up, you can still see the body. It's kind of like down low where these will come together underneath. Okay. Then, next, we need another really long piece split in half lengthwise so that we can wrap the whole kit and caboodle. So this is just another body wrap, and I want to kind of crisscross to hold on this belly bump. So I'm angling this way, and now I'm going to angle back this way. And I'm trying to keep the belly from shifting around as I do that, as I tug on it. You can make your donkey as fat or skinny as you want it to be. This one's looking like it needs a little more food, actually. Down in here, you just let this kind of come together. Don't attach it to the hind legs. You want those legs to be able to move independently.
Why do you want a skinny donkey? Nobody wants
a skinny donkey. You want a fat, little, feisty donkey. All right.